She asked the weather guy what they could expect, and she asked the sports reporter what that evening's sport roundup would be covering, before looking straight into the camera and thanking people for watching. Stella paused the replay and rewound to watch that part again. She had never taken a good look at Grieta before, never watched her carefully. She paused the replay right at the end of the broadcast, with Grieta looking directly into the camera, just as she had looked into her eyes in the lift. And Stella had to admit to herself that although on the screen Grieta appeared even tubbier, and you couldn't say that she was exactly pretty, she exuded a sexy energy. Maybe there was nothing so surprising about the pretty woman on Tinder wanting to see her again. Chapter 48. Ursula tiptoed to the front door and put her ear to it, listening for any sound outside. She held her breath and took care not to make the slightest sound with her every movement. She had no desire to have visitors, and whoever it was could hardly be paying a friendly call. These days, people had the manners to call ahead, as everyone knew how busy her family was now. It could hardly be anyone selling stuff from door to door, as it was getting on for 11 o'clock, and knocking after 10 was seen as the height of bad manners. She was startled by another knock. She felt its force pass through the wood and into her cheek. All that was between her and whoever stood outside were these hardwood planks. She wondered who was so determined they continued knocking when there had been no response after the first two attempts. Of course, it might be something completely innocent, a neighbour needing to borrow some milk or some such everyday errand. But Ursula was feeling the effects of the comments below the articles in the online newspapers, which she had been unable to resist reading, so she was terrified that whoever was standing outside meant her harm. At the same time, she was furious with herself for being so frightened. This was the woman who hadn't turned her hair when faced with an Ebola outbreak or a burst of machine gun fire.